Fans Beyond Wrestling, this is Denver, Colorado, and you should know by now just how important these debut matches are at Beyond Wrestling. You know, we like to give an opportunity to some of the up-and-coming talents on the independent scene to make a name for themselves, but that's Devin Moore. That's the CZW World Champion. This guy has certainly done a number making a name for himself. He doesn't need our help. This guy's reputation definitely precedes him. Devin Moore, known so affectionately as the Scumbag, and I have to wonder, what is he doing here in Beyond Wrestling? This is the CZW World Heavyweight Champion. I'll give him the opportunity. Let's hear him talk.
Let me explain to you.
What?
Fucking international, bro. Shut up.
Whoa.
I beat everyone. And this place sucks. I didn't even get dressed because it ain't worth it. I'm a CZW champ. Take this idiot's music. I'm going to drop a fucking rebel on it.
Thrilled that I decided to give Devin Moore the opportunity to talk. I probably should have just talked over him. It's not something that we want to hear. And what is his purpose of coming to Beyond Wrestling if it's not to do, you know, compete to the best of his ability? I don't really know what Devin Moore has to prove, but he has come out here to compete, and he is standing across the ring from Matt Tremont, a finalist in the IWA Deep South 2011 Carnage Cup. And perhaps he is here to see what Tremont can do live and in the flesh. Now, Tremont is a very, very dangerous competitor. I mean, our own Pinky Sanchez knows firsthand the type of fight that this guy can bring. I mean, Tremont, too. Anybody would miss Devin Moore at this point. He's certainly not endeared himself. I mean, there you see Pinky Sanchez already trying to pick a fight with him from the crowd. And look at this, just showboating on the outside of the ring. Get in there and fight. You know, I think being CZW World Heavyweight Champion, that comes along with a lot of responsibility. And Devin Moore is certainly not doing a good job representing his company here. This guy is a scumbag through and through. And he better be careful because he does not want to take Tremont lightly. I mean, this guy came to the ring with a chair. Moore better be careful, he's going to find that wrapped around his skull. And the official for this contest, Brett Lauderdale, who the majority is refereeing at CZW, you're going to wonder how lenient he's going to be with the rules. Tremont, though, actually going for a headlock. I wonder if that was just to get Moore in the position to remove his bandana that he put on, an obvious sign of disrespect. I think Devin Moore was expecting to be in this position this early on in the contest. Tell you what, the veteran's smart to get to the ropes, but Tremont is not letting off one bit, just firing away again and again in the corner. Now looking to shoot him across the ring, hard into the turnbuckle. Tremont building up ahead of steam. Just a big body avalanche. The CZW World Heavyweight Champion is in jeopardy right now. This guy is in trouble. And just getting out in the nick of time, a count of two. And now he's calling for a timeout, going to the corner. Tremont is going to charge in again. It was effective once. But Devin Moore stopping him in his tracks and putting a thumb in the eye and now showboating once again. Give me a break. Now, obviously, the CZW World Heavyweight title is not on the line. However, there is a point on the line. That's the rules of Beyond Wrestling. You win a match, you get a point. You lose a match, you lose a point. And I don't know if Devin Moore's purpose is to become a regular competitor on the Beyond Wrestling roster. If he just wanted to see what Tremont has firsthand, I don't know how effective that is. Throwing a Polar Spring water bottle package at him. Looks like Tremont is just getting infuriated. But, you know, Tremont, somebody who's decided that Beyond Wrestling is the platform that he wants to make a name for himself, obviously he's going to give it everything he's got because he wants that point. He wants to make a reputation for himself, a positive one, unlike Devin Moore. Now, Devin Moore, just staggering around, trying to get back up to his feet. He gets cracked over the skull one more time with one of those cookie sheets. Where the hell did that even come from? Oh, my God. Getting spiked. DDT right on the metal. Is that going to do it? Again, very, very smart veteran instincts from Devin Moore. He knew where he was in the ring. He got his foot on the bottom rope. He did not have to exert the energy for Tremont to break the hold. And I don't even think Tremont saw that. Well, he's stalking his opponent, gets cracked over the head, and a drop kick in the face to boot. But see, Devin Moore taking too much time now trying to impersonate Sabu. Ridiculous. And now setting up a chair in the middle of the ring. A triple jump moonsault. No, just smashing Tremont over the head again. And Tremont falls to the floor. He is in a bad way. I think he might be knocked out. There you see, looks like he just came to, realizing where he is. This kid's in the fight of his life right now. And now Devin Moore just throwing thumbtacks at his head. I don't know how effective that is. Certainly more annoying than anything. Getting under the skin of Tremont, trying to get him off his game, and now making the larger athlete chase him. You know, I'll give Moore credit. He has outsmarted Tremont at almost every turn, but Tremont has not let up. And again, I don't know if Devin Moore is known anywhere for being a great athlete. Certainly an effective wrestler nonetheless, but I don't know who's trying to impress doing the jumping jacks and push-ups. And now goading Tremont into the ring and just kicking the ropes. A low blow, and it looks like, I mean, obviously Lauderdale has let a lot go already in this contest. Oh, now just a vicious headbutt with that bit, and now a leaping headbutt. Tremont just staggering around, now down onto one knee. Devin Moore picking up that pin, but Tremont falls down in the meantime, now dropping that leg. I don't know how effective that was, but again, Devin Moore looks like he is firmly in control at this point. But that cocky pin, come on. Even if you had the guy knocked out, hook the leg. And here are the wrestlers on ringside, really trying to get Tremont to mount a comeback. Devin Moore, moment of hesitation. Tremont able to find the opening, and I don't even know what those are. Obviously, implements of destruction, just smashing away. And that drop kick right to the face. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. One, two. Oh, and again, the foot is on the rope. And you have to wonder, if Brett Lauderdale did not have to move that container out of the ring to get in position to be able to make that count, if Tremont wouldn't have been victorious here over the CZW champion. But again, another rookie mistake, taking time to argue with the referee. Referee isn't going to change his decision, allowing Devin Moore to continue the attack, but Tremont just shrugging it off. This kid is superhuman. Oh my God, just a punch shutting Devin Moore down. Picking him up, a big seated powerbomb. Is that gonna be it? No! Boy, was that close. And you can certainly tell how frustrated Tremont is. But this is the perfect opportunity to keep on his opponent. Devin Moore doesn't even know where he is right now. I mean, we've never even seen a match like this here at Beyond Wrestling. And you know, by allowing so many different debuting wrestlers to come through Beyond Wrestling, whether they're gonna be a permanent member of the roster, we're gonna bring you, the fans of Beyond Wrestling, all different styles of wrestling. This is a match we've never seen anything like here in Beyond Wrestling. I'm loving the hell out of it right now. And just Tremont, just chopping away. I mean, it's great to be able to give somebody who's a relative unknown the opportunity to compete against a world heavyweight champion. Where else are you gonna see action like this? Everybody comes into Beyond Wrestling with a clean slate. And Tremont, oh, he just got his clock clean. Coming off that top rope. Devin Moore out of the way. Tremont colliding face first in that chair. And now Devin Moore with the Yakuza kick. And that is gonna do it. Two, three. It was academic at that point. I'll tell you what though, I bet Tremont has impressed Devin Moore. He is going to go back to CZW officials, and you are going to be seeing this kid popping up in CZW in the not too distant future. And that is what Beyond Wrestling can provide to wrestlers. Opportunity. That is the name of the game. Sure, I wish Devin Moore would have come into the contest with a better attitude, but hey, he backed it up. He's victorious here at Miracle Workers, and I think that Tremont has earned the CZW World Champions respect. I'd love to see more of both of these guys here back at Beyond Wrestling, especially if Moore can change his attitude.